you think this video is crazy up till now, wait till you see the next one. Seemingly, there is another huge Mandela effect attached to aviation, in particular to the aircraft itself. Thanks to Moneybag73 for highlighting this in his recent video. Link is below. The engines now seem to be ridiculously and prominently much further forward on the wings than many of us recall. They were underneath the effing wings and pretty much covered up. This is not just a matter of gradual engineering change over time, with older planes being taken out of commission, thus no longer seen, giving the impression that this is sudden to us. No, no, no. Even photographs of older aircraft have the new version of the engine protruding out of the wings. In fact, so far, I have found none with the way it used to be. Clearly, it has always been this way. And what's more, there are now many old planes that have their engines on the fuselage and on the tail. This was not the case. Check it out for yourselves. Just Google the different passenger jets and Airbuses. They've all changed.
It has to do with the jet engines on commercial planes and their position on the wings. A lot of people remember the engines being a lot further back on the wings or even dead center. However, as it turns out, in most commercial planes, honestly, most of the ones that I found for all the major airlines, the engines are in front of the wings. And as you can see from all these images, most of these are all the major airlines, and they're all way up front. I personally remember the engines being a lot further back. What do you guys remember?
Hey folks, and welcome to another video from aplaintruth.info and questioning everything to find truth. Well, the Mandela effect is hitting the airline industry, it appears. I'm not sure which way to go, but look at how far they're putting the engines now in front of planes. I remember them always under the wing, maybe protruding a little bit forward, but definitely were parked underneath the wings. That's where they were located. That's why I've always known planes in my 60 years of flying. And I've always known them to be like this picture here on a Boeing 737 under the wings. But now the Mandela effect has taken another portal, another dimension. We don't know. But look at where they're putting these on the planes. They're putting them like in the very ahead of the wings now. They're in front of the wings. These are actual pictures they're telling us of actual planes at the airport. And there's the diagrams to boot showing that these engines are way, way in front of the airplane wing. And that's where they've always been. When you look at this Iberia here plane, and you see it's definitely under the wing. The others are shown in front. And there's another picture showing the engine way out in front and protruding so far ahead that it would certainly be noticeable. And I went through the Airbus diagrams, and they confirmed it as well. They've got the diagrams with the engines being in front. And the engine pylon is what it's called, is the supporting member to the wing, and the engine pylon. And that's the structure that is strutting out in front of the plane. But we have this Mandela effect between what we know and what we're seeing in images, and I can't wait to go to the airport and see for myself. But apparently the new engine is way out in front, and it's blowing hot air, thrusting. 90% of the thrust comes from these jets, blowing right up against the wing flaps. Can you imagine if they had to power up and they had the wing flaps down on landing, they had to power up? What would that do to the plane, folks? Look at this picture. I mean, this is photoshopped, obviously. You can see it, just there's no images, there's no details on these pictures. And when we get into it, we can see that the oddities just continue to exist. And if somebody can get their photo forensics out, I'm pretty sure we're going to find that we're going to see that some of these pictures, if not all of them, have been altered to bring in this new type of dimension of these jet turbojets. Look at this picture, folks. Does that even look like a plane? Look at that thing. Look at the short, stubby wings. Look at the huge engine in front. I mean, that looks like a comic, yet it's a real picture, according to wherever we got this from. But look at the cloud butt puffs in the back. They're saying this is a real picture of a real plane in the sky with a jet engine ahead of this tiny little whale. Look at the little cute little flags on the wings too. Definitely that was photoshopped. And here we see again, look at this wing. You can say it's because of the angle, but it's been shot from above. We should see the wing like the one on the right, but we don't. Look at how far ahead this jet engine is. And if the engine blows its thrust against the flaps, what's it going to do to the flaps, folks? It's just ridiculous. I don't remember anything like this. If I go to the airport and I see the planes all have engines in front, I'm not sure what to think anymore. And I think that's part of the game they're playing with us, is they don't want us to know what to think anymore and that we have to question everything. Here's the engine pylon holding it. And as you can see, this picture says it's reprofiled engine pylon, reprofiled. And if you look in some of these pictures, you can see they're different colors where the pylons are from the rest of the plane. So clearly something's been changed, something's different there. But here in this picture, you can see the engine pylon and the engine well out in front of it. So has things been doctored, or have they always been this way? And my thoughts of what I thought I knew are not true because it's been implanted in my brain that they were back and now I'm seeing something different because they really are front and I never saw it that way. Or have they changed all the images and the pictures and all the planes now are different? I don't know what to think, folks. This Mandela effect is really bringing into question what you think you know and what you think you've known. And as you can see here, there's engines clearly in front, but look at the purple there. Why isn't it purple on this engine? Look at how big that engine is compared to the others on the far side. So clearly, look at that engine. Clearly, that's been photoshopped on there. So there's clearly some shenanigans going on. And then look at this. Here we have the airport, the air exits, emergency exits. And look at how they have to move this ladder so it doesn't hit the engine, because they've moved the engine forward in the picture. So now they have to move the ladder forward. They wouldn't have designed it. Imagine the engine being all hot and sliding down. And here's the engine pylon I've been referring to and how they're showing how these engines are positioned in front of, I still can't get over it, in front of the wings. Well, let me know what you think. Here's 100 Mandela effect combined by Moneybag73. We appreciate it. We'll have in the show notes. Peace.
People remember Nelson Mandela dying in the 80s in prison. He actually died in 2013. The village people have an extra member now, a military guy. In the movie The Wizard of Oz, the Scarecrow now has a pistol.
I just wanted to show that he definitely has the gun. There you go, you can see it there. And that it's not a manipulated YouTube clip, because I've had some people say that.
I would turn back if I were you.
You can clearly see a revolver there. This is a creepy ass scene, by the way. There you go, see, it's still on my TV. This is the, I believe, 1939 version of the film as well. So I'll try and zoom in. And I'll see this. There you go, you can see the gun in the Scarecrow's hand again. There we go.
That's ridiculous.
The famous quote from Snow White, "Mirror, mirror on the wall," is now "Magic mirror on the wall."
Famous line that the witch in Snow White says in front of the mirror.
Yeah, mirror, mirror on the wall, who is the fairest of them all?
What?
Mirror, mirror on the wall, who's the fairest of them all?
Yeah. Mirror, mirror on the wall.
Mirror, mirror on the wall, who's the fairest of them all?
Let me see thy face.
What wouldst thou know, my queen?
Magic mirror on the wall. Who is the fairest one of all?
What's the magic mirror on the wall?
Magic
who is
mirror.
The fairest one of them all?
That just sounds stupid.
What do you guys remember? Do you guys?
The back of the eye sockets never had bone. Now it does. Tony the Tiger now has a blue nose instead of black. JCPenney is now JCPenney with an extra E. Hitler's eye color changed from brown to blue. Sally Field's famous Oscar acceptance speech line, "You like me, you really like me," has been changed to "You like me, right now, you like me."
They like me, they really like me, she just said. She's repeating, now you like me.
and I can't deny the fact that you like me. Right now, you like me. You love me.
Chuck E. Cheese is now Chuck E. Cheese's. Desi Arnaz is now Desi Arnaz. Procter & Gamble is now Procter & Gamble. The opening song for Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood has changed from It's a Beautiful Day in the Neighborhood to It's a Beautiful Day in This Neighborhood. An Interview with the Vampire has now been changed to An Interview with the Vampire. People remember the Mona Lisa being emotionless. Now she has a smirk.
I remember this argument all through the 90s and well into my career as a young illustrator in college, where everyone would seek out the Mona Lisa and stare at it for hours and hours because you couldn't tell whether she was smiling or whether she was kind of like neutral or what.
So everyone would talk about it at different angles.
That's right.
Oh, if you look at it from this angle, you see her looking like she's smiling. If you look at it from this angle, she just has a neutral expression.
But now
she's clearly smiling.
If you look at it from any angle, she's just smiling. Something weird happened there.
Home Depot is now the Home Depot. The Berenstain Bears are now the Berenstain Bears. The Staples logo now has a staple instead of an L. People remember Gene Wilder died in 2013. He actually died in 2016. The famous quote from I Love Lucy, "Lucy, you got some splaining to do," was never said. Oreo's Double Stuff is now spelled with a single F. Seth MacFarlane is now Seth MacFarlane. One of the famous quotes from The Wizard of Oz, "Fly my pretties fly," is now just "fly, fly, fly."
Oh, wow.
Fly, my pretties. Fly!
There it is. That was the movie. This is what it always was. Right here. Ready?
Take better care of those heavy shivers. I want those most of all. Now, fly!
Now, fly! 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 That's all it is. That's all it ever was in this reality. It was just, now fly, fly, fly.
During the assassination of President John F. Kennedy, people remember only 4 people in the car. Now there is 6. Cheez-Its is now Cheez-It. Oscar Mayer is now spelled M-A instead of M-E. C-3PO isn't all gold now. He has a silver leg. The Volkswagen emblem is now split. The Volvo emblem is now a male symbol. The Ford emblem now has a little loop in the F. Fruit Loops is now spelled with a double O in the word fruit. Skechers is now spelled without a T. People remember Sha Sha Gabor dying multiple times. The famous quote from Silence of the Lambs, "Hello Clarice," is now missing. Cup of Noodles. It's not cup noodles. Whiteout is not whiteout without an H. The Fruit of the Loom logo no longer has a cornucopia. People remember Katy Perry as Kate Perry. Johnny Walker whiskey is now spelled with an IE instead of a Y. People remember Gaddafi dying multiple times. Sally Field's last name no longer has an S. Johnny Quest is now spelled without an H. Folgers is now spelled Folgers without a D. People remember Castro dying in 2011. He actually died in 2016. Mickey Mouse no longer has suspenders. O'Reilly's Auto Parts is now O'Reilly Auto Parts. The classic Queen song, "We Are the Champions," no longer ends after "of the world." The "of the world" part is gone. In Star Trek, the famous quote, "Beam me up, Scotty," was never said. Gordon's is now Gorton's. Mike and Ike's is now Mike and Ike's. Dr. Doolittle is now spelled with a single O. Depends is now Depend. Elliot's Pizza is now Elio's Pizza. Gandhi's name is now spelled with an H at the end instead of the beginning. Vlasic only has one S now. Eddie's Ice Cream only has one D. Pennzoil now has two N's. Smokey the Bear is now just Smokey Bear. Pikachu's tail no longer has black in it. Lazy Boy is now Last Boy. Kit Kat no longer has a dash. Inspector Gadget no longer has a mustache past the pilot episode. Curious George no longer has a tail. People remember Sinbad in the Genie movie in the 90s, no such movie. The Star Wars line, Luke, I am your father, is now, no, I am your father.
When I first saw the dialogue that said, Luke, I am your father, I said to myself, he's lying.
Response to that.
Luke, I am your father.
Now, of course, when you watch the movie,
no, I am your father.
You hear him, he just says, no, I am your father.
Right, but everybody remembers it as Luke, I am your father.
No, and I mean, it's just, it's been on so many shows and in so many movies. I mean, everybody remembers it.
People remember Bill Nye dying in 2012. He's still alive. People remember the Monopoly Man having a monocle. Haley's Comet is now spelled with two L's. People remember a landmass right next to Australia on the west, no such mass now. People remember SpaghettiOs with a dash and an apostrophe at the end. People remember the tank man refusing to get out of the way and was run over. However, that's not the case, he actually just got on top of the tank. Vicks Vapor Rub no longer has an apostrophe S. Herbal Essence is now Herbal Essence with an S at the end. Coke Zero is now Coca-Cola Zero. Marilyn Monroe's beauty mark has changed location. In Phil Collins' song In the Air Tonight, the lyric has changed from Hold On to Oh Lord. Moses is now depicted with horns. Google Moses depicted in art to see more examples. OxyClean is now spelled with an I.
I mean, I remember this show. So it was super famous.
Sex in the City.
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 The show was on. I was always confused by what it was called because I kept hearing both names. I even thought it was changed at one point, but it turns out that it, according to the producers, it's always been Sex and the City.
This is a really very weird, strange one.
Instead of a Y. Sex in the City is now Sex and the City. People remember Cuba being smaller than it is today. In the Bible, the animal that will lay with a lamb is no longer the lion, but the wolf.
Specific part.
I'm not as familiar with the Bible as my father. My father actually was a Baptist minister. Yeah. So I called my father and I said, hey, that. And Isaiah, there's one part where he talks about a certain beast laying down with the lamb. And I said to my dad, I said, which beast lays down with the lamb? And he's like, well, it's the lion.
I'm not even a minister and I remember the lion and the lamb. That's like a saying, right?
Right. So if you read it now, it says wolf.
Chick-fil-A is now spelled with a CK. Jiffy Peanut Butter is now Jif. Febreze no longer has a double E. Before, Double Bubble was spelled with a single B in double. In the movie Field of Dreams, the famous quote, if you build it, they will come, is now, if you build it, he will come. The quote from the movie Forrest Gump, life is like a box of chocolates, is now, life was like a box of chocolates. The Barbie song lyrics used to be, I'm a Barbie girl in a Barbie world. It's now, I'm a Barbie girl in the Barbie world. Cliff Notes is now Cliff's Notes. Thanksgiving is no longer on the third Thursday of November. It is now on the fourth Thursday. People remember Harry Houdini's name as Henry Houdini. Daylight Savings Time no longer has an S. The Xbox logo now has a little tail in the back of the letter B. Looney Tunes is now spelled Looney Tunes. The Addams Family is now spelled with a double D. The famous quote from the movie Jaws, "We are gonna need a bigger boat," is now "You are gonna need a bigger boat." The Chevron logo now has the red on the bottom instead of the top. Hanes no longer has an I in it. Pixie Sticks is now spelled with a Y. And Ready Whip no longer has an H in the whip. Hello everyone, this is JC and I hope you enjoyed the video.
It's like a box of chocolates, you never know what you're gonna get.
Like Mama said, life is a box of chocolates, you never know what you're gonna get.
He says, Mama always said life is like a box of chocolates, you right. never know what you're gonna get. Okay guys, we got something special for you today. We managed to find a VCR. It wasn't easy. And we're gonna be showing you guys clips from these movies that prove our point about the Mandela Effect.
So even on the back of Forrest Gump, it even states, life is like a box of chocolates. So let's put this in.
You want a chocolate? I could eat about 1.5 million of these.
Me too.
My mom always said, life was like a box of chocolates. You never know what you're gonna get.
Okay.
He just said was.
Life was like a box of chocolates.
Do you remember watching James Bond Moonraker?
Oh yeah, of course.
Moonraker had a really famous villain in it. His name was Jaws, and he had these metal teeth. What happens in the movie is Jaws basically is on a tram and he crashes and he gets down. And when he gets off of the tram, this really sweet, pretty girl helps him. And there's this really like classic scene that everyone remembers where Jaws sees her and he smiles and she smiles and she has braces. Well, okay, but now if you go back and watch it, she doesn't have braces.
What? So weird. So I remember the light shining off her braces.
Off of her braces.
And then the music gets all loud, and then it's like, oh, they're falling in love because they both have metal mouths.
That scene doesn't even make that much sense anymore.
And the movie doesn't even make sense anymore either.
And you knew who you were then. Girls were girls and men were men.
That's right. He remembers like me. Thumb this video up if you remember like me. Thumb it down if you don't. There's a link here, you can probably see it now, to my first 122 voting videos. Click. If not, in the top 10 biggest Mandela effects ever. I mean, it's game over. According to Una Mundi, where I found this, I'm going to share his video and I'm going to link you to his channel. Oh my gosh, this is crazy.
Goodbye, Norma Jean.
Yep, goodbye Norma Jean, because she never existed in this reality.